Here's a bit more of my work on my Pip-Boy 3000. I haven't got my 3D printer yet, and don't expect it for a while. So in the meantime, I've put all the components for the controls into a dodgy cardboard box. There's the encoder for the rotating thing. Breadboard there. With the TNC2. I had a TNC3 up until a couple of hours ago when I put 12 volts through it and killed it. So that's annoying, but I still had a TNC2, so I'm using that now instead. There's the Raspberry Pi. I've mounted the TFT monitor and the lens in more of a position where they would be in the once I got the Pip-Boy made. Put your stuff there. So that's just layers of cardboard holding it apart slightly. It works quite nicely. Looks like a CRT. Sort of. Just got the log in there. You see, I've been. When I rotate that, that presses QWERT. When I press these, that is 1, 2, 3. It should do. Except it doesn't always. Oh, yeah. Sometimes it doesn't respond, and sometimes it presses the button too much. So. I'm hoping I can find a way around that. The Raspberry Pi doesn't seem to like the TNC as a keyboard. At least my current distribution of the OS doesn't anyway. This is the Adafruit Occidentalis distribution. And I don't know if they've done anything to fix anything recently. Okay, let's run the actual doodah. Be making progress on this. Where are we? Okay. Ooh, got sound as well. Yeah, that's turned on. Got a nice X-Mini speaker there. I need to make a proper. Well, I need to make my own amplifier and speaker to go in the actual device, but this works for now. Okay, running. Now you'll see, I've added a RobCo bootup bit at the start, like on the terminals in Fallout 3. Is that actually doing anything? Come on. No, of course it isn't. Just a moment. Refresh. Ugh. This makes a terrible video. There we go. You'll see that this knob here makes the cursor go up and down because I've got that attached to the cursor keys. This here, which is the knob that'll go on the hand, I can't show you here because that's obviously not a Windows interface, but turning left and right turns it left and right. Well, no, sorry, it moves the mouse cursor left and right. If I push it down, because it's got a clicky button, and then rotate it, that moves it up and down. So just with this one knob, I can move the mouse around, and then the button on the side, which will be on the side of the Pip-Boy, that clicks the mouse button. I'm going to use that for selecting. Well, I'll use that for scrolling the map around, and that for just selecting in general. Okay, come on. I could edit this out, but I really can't be bothered, so I won't. Reloading. use an awful lot of hot glue there to hold that on. It's a wonderful material for making anything out of. Actually, I should show this at some point, but a couple of years ago I made a non-working Pip-Boy out of paper, expanding foam, paint, and an iPhone, and the buttons, as in the ones that lit up, these ones here, I actually made the buttons that sit on top of the LEDs out of hot glue that I used I made a mould out of clay that I'd pushed a pen into, and then used a glue gun to fill that, and then made the little the buttons to go on top. That worked quite nicely. I might do something similar for the actual buttons when I make them. Oh, goodness knows what that's going to look like. I'm not sure. I might end up making them via shapeways or something. I'll work something out. But I need to find some way of making see-through parts. Because everything else is going to be made with my 3D printer when I get that. But I don't think that will do. Well, I might be able to do slightly translucent stuff if I use the right filament, but I don't think it would be of the quality that I want for that. Okay, here we go. Oh, at last it's got there. Right, here we go. Starting. Right, here we go. Here's the RobCo boot up. Focus. There we go. This text was taken straight out of Fallout 3. And the rest of the text is my stuff, where it's finding the GPS stuff. Now, I didn't find it because I'm indoors. That's using my default coordinates, the last coordinates I found. And it's using Google Geo processing to find out what city that is, and it's, as you see, it downloaded a local map and a world map. Now, if I turn this, as you see, sometimes the keyboard presses don't go through. I need to find a way to fix that somehow. Click. And there you go, there's the local map. There's my house there. I live around here somewhere. And for the world map, I've got it's a map of Leeds. And this is downloaded and processed just then. So when it was booting up, it downloaded this map from Google Maps, changed the contrast, changed the brightness, stuck the grid lines on it. Job's a good one. What I need to do is make it scrollable when I move this around, and clickable, and I'm going to use that to zoom in and out as well. So yeah, that should be pretty good. I think that's it for now. Okay. Good night.